We will interrupt all programs to give you latest news bulletins. Stay tuned to this station.
We were told by Liz Cheney and all of the globalists that if we accepted globalism, we would export America's best crops, best products, best services. But instead, all too often, we are exporting America's bravest patriots to die in foreign distant lands. A nation that sends its best to go fight in the worst places in the world should not send its worst to be representatives in the United States Congress. But we are here in happy spirit and joy because we do not have to accept failure or losing. We do not have to be condemned to some grim fate. We're Americans. And if there's a fight for the soul of this country, we intend to win it. Our fellow Americans aren't going to be living like the folks in the Portland, Oregon Autonomous Zone or the Chaz. Our fellow Americans aren't going to accept New York's silly lockdowns that constrain freedom. Our fellow Americans aren't going to live on the feces-stained sidewalks of San Francisco. No, President Donald J. Trump showed us that with strong borders, with a focused foreign policy, with less regulation, with less involvement from Washington and with lower taxes, America's best days are still yet to come. Don't you ever let some spoiled celebrity or athlete or socialist politician ever tell you otherwise. America, America's not just an idea. It's not just the Constitution. America is our home. And we must protect our home. One thing America's not, America is not some vaccine to global tyranny that we have to administer through decades of military occupations in foreign lands. No, success means we honor how special America is. And it also means that we have to see our leaders for who they truly are.
Amen.
Now, Liz Cheney taunts me for wearing makeup in my television appearances. Now, makeup only hides the slightest imperfections of the skin. It does very little to conceal the soulless corruption of Washington, D.C. You know, it's pretty easy for me to get a little makeup off my shirt. Far more difficult for Liz Cheney to get the blood off her hands after sending America's best to foreign lands to die for unknowable gain and personal profit. 80% of Taliban fighters have never been more than 20 miles from their own home. And so it's a little confusing to me why Liz Cheney's always fighting in Congress to spend more money in Kandahar and in Arabia than in the great state of Wyoming. But maybe it shouldn't surprise us all that much. In 2016, in that election cycle, Liz Cheney announced her candidacy for Congress from Wyoming, from Virginia. How out of touch! How untouchable she must think she is. Now, the neocons say, we gotta fight them abroad so we don't have to fight them at home. Well, maybe we have to fight them abroad because we are abroad so much. You know, I was gonna say, maybe we ought to fight the neocons at home so we don't have to fight them in Washington, D.C. But that's the problem, isn't it? Because the neocons are at home in Washington, D.C. Liz Cheney and I came to Congress in the same class, but she was already a master of the ways of the Beltway in ways I will never be. Because she's lived there for all but about 2 years of her life. That was a little bit of a problem when she wanted to run for the United States Senate here in Wyoming. She claimed to be a resident of the state for 10 years based on a fishing license. Of course, she wasn't, and she quickly withdrew. By my count, that's the last time a Cheney had a viable exit strategy. We are here in the Cowboy State. Now, I understand that, you know, the media, they used to call Bush Cheney cowboys abroad, but I think that's a slur, because the cowboys I know, sure, they're tough and they're brave, but they're also judicious and smart and thoughtful and tender and gentle when the cause comes. Not exactly what you think about when you think of disloyal Liz Cheney. Now, the real cowboys, I guess they fought Indians so that they could use the land. But what are America's soldiers even fighting for that Liz Cheney sends all around the world? What are the great benefits that we all get from our misadventures in Syria and Afghanistan and Somalia? Places that a lot of Americans couldn't even point to on a map. You see, real cowboys, they would have found greener pastures than Afghanistan, and it wouldn't have taken them 20 years to do it. We are here in Wyoming, and in a lot of ways, this feels like the most American of states. Self-reliant, on the frontier, maybe a little hard to get to. And so how is it then that Wyoming has such a disappointing congresswoman? I guess you have to ask yourself the question, why is it that America has such a disappointing Congress? Because in a lot of ways, Liz Cheney is exactly like Congress. Deeply unpopular and owned by special interests.
Please smack the like and subscribe buttons below. Be sure to like and subscribe below.